What's up, YouTube? I have a fantastically interesting video for you today. If you are watching this, you either have a deep love for technology guts or your phone is broken and you want me to show you how to fix it. Well, you're in the right spot. Today I'm going to show you how to do a glass-only iPhone repair with dry ice. If you are subscribed to my channel already, you are seriously the best type of human. If you have not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and buckle up. We are going to jerry-rig all of the things. So I have two cracked but completely functional iPhone screens in front of me that have already been removed from their phones. The black one is an iPhone 6 and the white one is an iPhone 5. You can watch my previous videos for the screen removal process. This particular video is just explaining the dry ice glass removal. I've paid about $5 for this block of dry ice. Now, iPhone screens are made up of a few different layers. The important layers that you need to worry about is the top layer, which is just glass. Under that, you have the digitizer layer and the LCD. Both of these are fused together in one unit and is about as fragile as an eggshell. You think I'm joking about the eggshell stuff, but I'm not. It is very fragile. Now, normally when a tech does a glass-only repair, they either have super expensive refurbishing equipment or it is possible to use a heat gun to bring the phone up to 100 degrees Celsius to melt the glue between the top layer and the LCD layer. It is a difficult and painstaking process. Now, I was on the phone with TechMD, another YouTube channel, about a week ago, and we were talking about the new liquid nitrogen machines that can freeze off the glass. These liquid nitrogen machines can get down to about negative 140 degrees Celsius, which is incredibly cold, but the machines cost thousands of dollars. Now, dry ice, while not as cold as liquid nitrogen, does get down to about negative 80 degrees Celsius and is available at most grocery stores. So I was curious to see if it was cold enough to accomplish a glass-only repair. And it was. As you've seen, I set the broken glass screens down on the dry ice and let it sit for about 5 or 10 minutes to get to temperature. Then I can lift up the screen and gently twist it with my hands to break away the glass from the LCD. When I tell you to be gentle, I mean gentle. It's like trying to flex a Dorito without cracking it. I was able to use a razor blade and playing cards to help persuade the glass off of the LCD. The iPhone 6 screen was easier than the iPhone 5 screen. The nice thing about dry ice is that it's never actually a liquid, so you don't have to worry about liquid damaging your screens. It goes from an icy solid to a gas through a process called sublimation. Now, this is also important to know because dry ice is made up of solid carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is not as good as oxygen when it comes to staying alive. So make sure that you open any windows in your car or kitchen when you're transporting this stuff. I don't want any dead do-it-yourselfers out there. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoy oxygen. I'm going to test the iPhone 6 screen by plugging it back into the phone, and everything functions. Yeah, science. It still has glue residue on the screen, so I will need to clean that off, apply the liquid optical adhesive and the new glass layer, but all of that will be explained at the 8 minute and 20 second mark in the linked video. Dry ice is also extremely cold and can burn you. Yes, ice can burn. Treat it like hot coal from a fire. Wear gloves if you have to touch it directly. I imagine that with a $5 block of ice like this one, an experienced tech could repair about 4 or 5 phones before it sublimates into oblivion. The more glass I remove from the screen, the quicker the screen warms up, so I have to keep setting it on the block of ice to cool down and get the glue brittle again before I can break off more glass. The iPhone 5 was much more shattered than the iPhone 6, but with my razor blade I could put a little pressure on each shard of glass and break it off individually. It is much easier to work on a cold phone than a hot phone. When I do this repair with heat, it is blazing hot and almost untouchable the entire time. Now, for those of you attempting this repair, keep in mind that even though both of my phones were successful, I've been doing this for a while. For noobs, the success rate is very low. I've broken hundreds of screens trying to get good at this, so it might be more cost-effective and healthier for your sanity to just buy the complete screen and install that, instead of trying to attempt the brain surgery equivalent of cell phone repair. As you can see, the iPhone 5 is also fully functional. If you want to watch the glue cleaning and liquid optical adhesive application and the installation of the new glass, click the link and watch the video here starting at the 4-minute mark. Make sure to keep the LOCA glue off the edges of the LCD so it does not seep into the backlight. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing. My viewers like you make videos like this possible. I appreciate it a ton. Leave any questions in the comments, and I hope to see you around.